Hello friends, welcome to MATLAB School. In this video, we are going to simulate regenerative braking in electric vehicle employing induction motor. The same file is available for download in the link given in the description. If you want, you can download it. Let us get into the simulation part. So this is the model of regenerative braking in induction motor. Here we have the induction motor, three-phase induction motor. The other name of three-phase induction motor is asynchronous motor. Okay. So here I am employing a simple V by F control to run the motor. See, while we are running the motor, we will be applying the brake. So whenever brake is applied, you can see the current flowing in the negative direction. That is, normally the current flow will be from the battery to the motor. During the time of regenerative braking, the flow of current will be from the motor to the battery. Okay, so that we will be seeing in the simulation. Okay, so these are the parameters of the three-phase induction motor, and the mechanical input is in the form of torque. Okay. So here we have the brake pedal. The severity of the brake depends on the slider. See, if the slider position is here, that represents extreme braking or heavy braking, and whenever a slight braking is needed, this slider can be moved slightly from zero. Okay, so here I'm giving 1500 rpm as the reference, and these two are the magnitude. This represents the magnitude of the voltage, and this one represents the conversion of speed to frequency, so that we are maintaining a constant ratio of V by F, and this will give the output of three phase sine PWM and sine wave. And to produce the PWM, we have the PWM generator block. Okay, so this is the PWM generator block. The output of this block will be varying from -1 to 1. Okay, the maximum values are -1 and 1. Here we have the control. See, as per the position of the brake pedal, this block will give the signal to the next block whether the motor has to be in on condition or whether it has to be in off condition. And the output of this will be going to the next stage. Yes. This portion is the inverter circuit. It's a three-phase 6-switch inverter, and here we have the regenerative braking part or control system for regenerative braking. Here I am assuming a maximum current to be 5. See, it can be represented here based on the rated value of the motor. Okay, this is basically the rated value of motor. If the rated value of motor, rated current capacity of motor is 10 amps, you can put it 10 here. And here we have the P controller, and here we have a DC PWM generator. In PWM generator, the carrier signal will be varying from 0 to 1. So this will give the output to the next stage. This second pin is connected to the previous block. That will give the signal whether the motor has to be on or off. Okay, and the output is given to the AND gate. Then again, it is given to the inverter gates. This block will measure the voltage, and this will measure the current. Okay. Here we have the block. This will give the output of 0 when the speed equals 0. Okay, otherwise, in an electric vehicle, whenever the speed goes to zero, even if you continuously give torque to the rotor of the motor, the vehicle tends to move in the reverse direction. Okay, to stop that, we are giving just zero when the speed comes to zero. Okay, so it will continuously measure the speed, and whenever the speed reaches zero, automatically the torque input goes to zero. And during other times, the torque would be 5. Let us run the model. I am giving infinite value here because it will run continuously till you press the stop button. But if you give any fixed value, the simulation will stop once the time is reached. The model is running. Let's reduce the size of this. We shall open the scope. Yes, since we have given 1500 as the reference value, the speed is, yes, you can see the speed just settling around 1500 RPM. Since this being a induction motor, you cannot see the speed reaching the given input, okay, since due to the presence of slip. If you go for closed loop control, you can make the speed to settle at exactly at 1500 RPM. Okay. Now I am going to apply the speed. You see the change in. I am going to apply the brake. You can see the change in speed as well as the change in current and power. Okay. I am going to apply extreme braking now. You can see the speed going to zero. And whenever we applied the brake, you can see the current going in the negative direction. Okay. See the spike in current. Right. See, if you apply sudden braking, the speed will abruptly come down to zero. Then I am running the motor. Okay. I will remove the brake. So you can see the speed increasing. Yes, the speed is now settling around 1500 RPM. Now I'm going to apply a mild brake. I'm running the motor. So you can see the slope difference. If you apply a mild, further mild brake, very mild brake, you can see the speed decreasing very slowly. Okay. Let me show it. Now the speed has reached around 1500 RPM. I'm applying a very mild brake. Now I raise the speed. Okay. So based on the braking pattern, you can see the regeneration. See here, I have shown you three different types of braking pattern. See the first pattern is heavy braking. Okay, so during heavy braking, the reverse current will be maximum, and during mild braking, the current, negative current, would be somewhat lower. Okay, yes, the same model is available for a download in the link given in the description. If you want, you can download and use it. Please subscribe our channel and share it to your friends. Thanks for watching.